Thank you. Yeah. Παρά Χριστό το Αχάντο Βασιλεί και Θεό ημών ετής όνειθα.
Παράσχω Κύριε.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord have mercy.
For you are the resurrection, the life and the repose. Of the departed sons of God, Ioannis, born asleep, O Christ, our God, and to you ascribe glory, together with your beginningless Father, and your holy, good, and laughing Spirit, now and always, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. Εχει ρε σου επίσαν με και πλάσαν με, συνέτησον με και μαθήσω με τα σέντολα σου. Ελέησον με Κύριε.
Though I feel like a one thing that you abandoned, I have not forgotten your rules of life. Be merciful to me, O Lord.
Σώσι μη εγώ, σώσον με, ότι τα δικαιώματα σου εξεζήτησα. Ελέησον με Κύριε.
From all your instructions, Lord, have I never strayed, for you have given me the law. Be merciful to me, O Lord.
Έκλεινα την καρδία μου, του ποιήσε τα δικαιώματά σου εις τον αιώνα διανταμείψην. Ελέησον με Κύριε.
My Lord, for you to act the time is upon us, for they have transgressed your law. Be merciful to me, O Lord.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Υιό Πνεύματι.
Εν ειν και εις τον αιώνα μην.
Ελέησον με Κύριε, Κύριε.
Ελέησον με Αλληλούια.
Επίβλεψον επ' εμέ και ελέησον με κατά το κρίμα των αγαπώντων το όνομά σου. Αλληλούια. Νεότερος εγώ είμαι και εξουδενωμένος τα δικαιώματα σου και πελαθώμη. Αλληλούια.
My pleading voice, hear my Lord in your great mercy, and in your justice grant me life. Alleluia.
Άρχοντες κατεδίωξαν με δωρεάν και από τον λόγον σου εδηλίασεν η καρδία μου. Alleluia.
Let my soul live and it shall praise and your ordinances shall assist me. Αλληλούια.
Επλανήθην ως πρόβατον απολωλός, ζήτησον των δούλων σου, ότι τα σέντολά σου ου και πελαθώμην.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε, διδαξών με τα δικαιώματά σου, τον Αγίον ο χορός έβρε πηγήν της ζωής και θύραν παραδείσου. Ευρωκαγώ την οδόν διά της μετανοίας, το απολωλός φεύατον εγώ είμαι, ανακάλεσε με σωτήρ και σώσον με.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε, διδαξών με τα δικαιώματά σου, ο πάλε με, εκ μειόντος πλάσας με, και εικόνη σου θεία τιμήσας. Παραβάσι εντολής δε πάλι με επιστρέψας, εις γην εξισελήφθην, εις το καθομοίο συνεπανάγαγε, το αρχαίον καλός αναμορφώσαστε.
Blessed are you, Lord, teach me your rules of life. I con am I of your ineffable glory, even though the marks of sin are on me. Take pity, Lord, on your own creation, and cleanse me in your compassion, and my cherished son, and do you grant to me, making me again a citizen of paradise.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε, διδαξών με τα δικαιώματά σου, ανάπαυσον, ο Θεός των δούλων σου, και κατάταξον αυτόν εν παραδείσο, όπου χωρεί των Αγίων Κύριε και οι δίκαιοι εκλάμψουσιν ως φωστήρες των και κοιμημένων δούλων σου ανάπαυσον παρορών αυτού πάντα τα εγκλήματα.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, the tri-brilliance of the Godhead singleness, let us praise reverently chanting. Holy are you, the beginningless Father, the co-beginningless Son, and the Holy Spirit. Shine upon us in faith, worship you, and deliver us all from the eternal fire.
Και νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων, αμήν. Χαίρεσαι μνή, η Θεός αρχιτεκούσα εις πάντων σωτηρίαν. Διείς γένος των ανθρώπων εύρατο την σωτηρίαν. Δια σου ευρημέν παράδεισον Θεοτό και αγνή ευλογημένη.
Αλληλούια, 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 δόξα σοι ο Θεός.
Αλληλούια, 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 δόξα σοι ο Θεός.
Αλληλούια, 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 glory to you, O God.
Μετά τον Αγίον ανάπαυσον Χριστέ την ψυχή πάντα σκιά αθνέστερα, πάντα ονείρων απατηλότερα. Μία ροπή και ταύτα πάντα θάνατος διαδέχεται. Άλλεντο φωτί Χριστέ του προσώπου σου και το γλυκασμό της ισορρεότητος ον εξελέξω ανάπαυσον ως φιλάνθρωπος.
Πάντα ματαιότητα ανθρώπινα όσα ουχ υπάρχει με τα θάνατον. Ου παραμένει ο πλούτος, ου συνοδεύει η δόξα. Επεσόν γάρος άνατος, ταύτα πάντα εξυφάνιστε. Διο Χριστό το αθανάτο βασίλη βοήσομε, τον μεταστάντα εξ ημών ανάπασον, εν θα πάντων εστί εφαινομένον η κατοικία.
Όντως φοβερότατον το του θανάτου μυστηρίο, πως ψυχή εκ του σώματος βιαίως χωρίζεται εκ της αρμονίας και της συμφίας ο φυσικότατος δεσμός θείο βουλήματι αποτέμνεται, διό σε οικετεύομεν τον μεταστάντα ανάπαυσον εν σκηνές των δικαίων σου ζωοδότα φιλάνθρωπε.
Where is all the earthly activity? Where are the imaginings of the here and now? Where is the gold and the silver? Where is the multitude and the noise of the servants? All are dust, all are ashes, all just a screen. But come, let us raise our voices to the mortal King. Lord, count worthy of eternal joy him who has been taken from us by granting him rest in the ageless state of blessedness.
Εμνήσθη του προφήτου βόντος, εγώ είμαι γη και σποδός και πάλι κατενόησα εν της μνήμαση και είδων τα οστά τα γεγυμνωμένα και είπων. Άρα της εστί βασιλεύς, η στρατιώτης, η πλούσιος υπένης, η δίκαιος η αμαρτωλός. Αλλά να πάψον Κύριε με τα δικαίων των δούλων σου ως φιλάνθρωπος.
My origin and my very being come from your creative command. For at your will you fashioned me a living being from invisible and visible nature. You formed my body from the earth and you gave me a soul by your breath, the life-giving and divine. So Christ, rest your servant in the land of the living and the dwellings of the righteous.
Ανάπαυσον σωτήρι μόν ζωδότα, ον μετέστη σας αδερφών ημών, εκ των προσκέρων κράζοντα δόξα σοι.
Your image and likeness you created man in the beginning, and you placed him in paradise to rule over your creatures. But deceived by the envy of the devil, he tasted of the fruit and became a violator of your commandments. Therefore you condemned him to the earth from which he came, Lord, to entreat you for eternal rest.
Θρηνώ και οδύρωμε όταν εννοήσω τον θάνατον και είδω εν της τάφης κειμένη την κατοικώνα Θεού. Πλαστήσαν ημίν ωραιότητα άμορφον άδοξον μη έχουσαν είδος, ο του θαύματος τι το περί μας, του το γεγονε μυστηριών, πως παρεδόθη μεν τη θωρά και συνεζεύθη μεν το θανάτο, όντως Θεού προς τάξιος γεγράπτε, του παρέχοντος της μεταστάσει την ανάπαυση.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Αγίο Πνεύματι, ως θάνατος σου Κύριε Αθανασίας γεγονέ προξενός, ημί γαρε μνηματικά τετέθης, ούκανο παράδεισος είναι οκτώ, διότον μεταστάντα ανάπαυσον, ως φιλάνθρωπος.
Ενήν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων αμήν. Αγνή παρθένε του λόγου πύλη, του Θεού ημών μητήρ, οικέτευε ελεήθηνε την ψυχήν αυτού.
Blessed are the poor in spirit. Father, poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called sons of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they revile and persecute you, and say all kinds of evil against you falsely for my sake. Rejoice and be exceedingly glad, for great is your reward in heaven.
Εν τη βασιλεία σου μνησιτή μον Κύριε, μακάρι πτωχή το πνεύμα, διότι αυτόν εστίν η βασιλεία των ουρανών. Μακάρι πενθούντες ότι αυτοί παρακληθήσονται. Μακάρι πραείς ότι αυτοί κληρονομήσουσι την γη. Μακάρι πεινώντες και διψώντες την δικαιοσύνη, ότι αυτοί χορταστήσονται. Μακάρι ελεήμονες, ότι αυτοί ελεήθησονται. Ληστήν του παραδείσου, Χριστέ πολίτη, επί σταυρούσι βοήσαντα το μνησθητή μου προαπηργάσω αυτού της μετανοίας αξίωσον καμέ των ανάξιων.
Μακάρι καθαριστικά διότι αυτοί των θεών όξονται το ίσο κυριεύουν και τους θανάτους εν θέσαυλες Αγίων ανάπαυσον τον προσελάβου εκ των προσκέρων, πόντα μνηστική μου, όταν έθεσε τη βασιλεία σου.
Μακάρι ειρηνοποιεί, ότι αυτοί Θεού κληθήσονται, ο των ψυχών δεσπόζων και των σωμάτων, που επιχειρεί πνοή ημών των θλιβωμένων παραμυθία. Ανάπαυσον εν χώρα δικαίων, πον μετέσχισα θούλων σου.
Μακάρι δεδμένε και δικαιοσύνη, ότι αυτόν εστίν η βασιλεία των ουρανών. Χριστός σε αναπαύσει εν χώρα ζώντων, επίλας παραδείσου ανήξουσι, και βασιλεία ζήξει πολίτη, και άφεσιν σι ζωή, ονείμαστες εν δύο φιλόχριστες.
Μακάρι έστε όταν ονειδήσωσι ημάς και διώξωσι και ύποσι παν πονηρό ρήμα καθημών ψεθόμενοι ένε και νε μου εξέρθομεν και είδομεν εν της τάφης ότι γυμνά ως θέα ο άνθρωπος σκορδίκον βρώμα και δυσοδεία και γνώμεν της ο πλούτος το καλός ισχύς και η ευπρέπεια.
Χαίρετε καλιάς το μισθός ημών πολλής εν της ουρανής ακούσομεν τι κράζει ο παντοκράτορ που εξετούντες θεάσαστε την φοβεράν ημέραν Κυρίου. Αυτή γαρές τη σκότος, πυρίγαρ δοκιμάσει τα σύμπαντα.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Υιό Πνεύματι, ανάρχο και γεννήσιτε και πρόοδο, Πατέρα προσκυνώτων γεννήσαντα, Υιόν δοξάζω τον γεννηθέντα, υμνώτος είναι κλάμπον, Πατρίτε και Υιό Πνεύμα Άγιον. Και νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων αμήν, πως εκ μαζών σου γαλαβρείς παρθένε, πως τρέφεις τον τροφέα της κτήσεως, ως είδεν ο πήγας ασίδωρ εκ πέτρας, τας φλέγαβας των υδάτων, διψώντι το λαό καθώς γεγράπτε.
Μακαρία Υιός Ζωός, υπορεύεις ημερών, ότι ετοιμάστης τόπος αναπαύσεως.
Μακαρία Υιός Ζωός, υπορεύει σήμερον, ότι ετοιμάστησι τόπος αναπαύσεως.
Blessed always be the road that you travel on today, because for you has been prepared a place of eternal rest. Πρόσκομε.
Προσέ, Κύριε, και κράξω με ο Θεός μου.
Σοφία.
Προς Θεσσαλονικής πρώτης επιστολής Παύλου το ανάγνωσμα.
Πρόσκομε.
Αδελφοί, ου θέλω ημάς αγνοήν περί των και κοιμημένων, ή να μη λυπήστε, καθώς οι λυποί ή μη έχοντες ελπίδα. Ή γαρ πιστεύομαι ότι Ιησούς απέθανε και ανέστη, ούτω και ο Θεός τους κοιμηθέντας δια του Ιησού άξισιν αυτό. Τούτο γαρ ημίν λέγομαι εν λόγω Κυρίου, ότι εμείς οι ζώντες υπεριλυπόμενοι εις την παρουσίαν του Κυρίου, που μη φθάσομεν τους κοιμηθέντας, ότι αυτός ο Κύριος εγγελεύσματι εν φωνή Αρχαγγέλου και εν σάπιγγι Θεού καταβίσεται απ' ουρανού, και οι νεκροί εν Χριστώ αναστήσονται πρώτον. Έπειτα εμείς οι ζώντες υπεριλυπόμενοι, άμα συν αυτής αρπαγισόμεθα εν εφέλες, εις απάντησιν του Κυρίου εις αέρα. Και ούτω πάντοτε συν Κυρίω εσώμεθα. And with your spirit.
The reading is taken from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. Let us attend.
Glory to you, O Lord, glory to you.
The Lord said to the Jews who came to him, I tell you the truth. Whoever hears my words and believes in him who sent me has eternal life. He will not be judged, but has already passed from death to life. I tell you the truth, the time is coming, the time has already come, when the dead will hear the words of the Son of God, and those who hear it will live. Even as the Father is himself the source of life, in the same way has made his Son to be the source of life, and he has given the Son the right to judge, because he is the Son of Man. Not be surprised at this, for the time is coming when all the dead in the graves will hear his voice, and they will come forth, those who have done good deeds, resurrection of life, and those who have done evil deeds to resurrection of judgment. I can do nothing on my own authority. As I hear, I judge, and my judgment is just, because I do not seek my own will, but the will of the Father who sent me.
Glory to Lord, to you, Lord. Glory to you.
Acquaint you των απάξεως της ψυχής του προκειμένου γλουσσού Ιωάννου και πέτσου εθήνε αυτό πάμπλημεν ακούσουν τε και ακούσιον.
Κύριε λέησον, Κύριε λέησον, Κύριε λέησον.
Through all places of the righteous rest and grant him the mercies of God, the kingdom of heaven and the forgiveness of all his sins, let us ask of Christ, our immortal King and God.
Grant this, O Lord.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O God, of spirit and of all flesh, who has trampled on death, crushed the power of the devil and granted life to the world, do yourself, O Lord, give rest to the soul of the departed Son of God, Ioannis, who has fallen asleep in a place of light. Amen.
Amen.
A place of green pasture.
Amen.
A place of repose.
Amen.
Where there is no grief, sorrow, or mourning.
Amen.
Forgive every sin which has committed in word, or deed, or thought. For you are a good God who loves mankind.
Amen.
For there is no one who lives and does not sin, only you without sin. Your righteousness is an everlasting righteousness, and your word is truth. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For you are the resurrection, the life, and the repose. I departed, Son of God, Ioannis, who has fallen asleep, O Christ our God, and to you is our glory, together with the beginningless Father, and your holy, good, and laughing Spirit, now and always, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to our God, I have glory to you. May Christ our true God, who rose from the dead, and has dominion over the living and the dead, as immortal King, through intercessions of his most pure and undefiled Mother, of the holy glories and all prayers, the apostles, of our holy and God-bearing fathers, of the holy and glorious forefathers Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, of his holy and righteous friend Lazarus, who was 4 days in a tomb, and of all the saints, assigned the dwelling place of the righteous, the soul of his servant Ioannis, who departed from among us, granted rest in the bosom of Abraham, amen, numbered among the righteous,
amen,
may also have mercy upon us and save us,
amen.
Who is a good and merciful God who loves mankind. Ioannis, in name maximakai, the gamest and femon, may remember we turn our ever blessed and ever brother in Christ. Ioannis, in name maximakai, the gamest and ever fair imam. Of anguish, those of pain, and those of challenge. within those moments, however, it is where we find ourselves, we find God, we find the reality, and it is in those moments that we find resurrection, where we find Christ, where we find His light, we find His joy, we find His hope. And it's always very important for us then to remember this, to not live this as a brief moment, because as we say in the prayers, we almost funnel time into a moment. We funnel our lives and all the experiences and all the joys and difficulties into a single moment where they all become meaningful only in the fact that we have in front of us in a moment where our life, as I said, reveals to us the truth of life, the truth of Christ, the truth of God. And that is what opens up when we pass away and when our eyes continue, they do not close, they continue to see the reality of the other side. The reality, however, we must remember is already here and is already with us, and we are already experiencing it. And many times, as one of the fathers said, we almost try and celebrate what our church celebrates as the biggest feast, which is the resurrection of Christ, because with that we also resurrect. We almost celebrate it, but especially so today, we seem to be celebrating it, the resurrection of God, of a living God, but with a lot of fear. And you cannot celebrate resurrection, correctly speaking, when we are fearing and we have understanding of things that are very mortal, very, very short-lived. And it is in these moments, as we said, that the truth of the resurrection and the life must give us, although we're grieving, must give us hope in God's mercy and God's love. It's very important for us, therefore, to always remember to stay close to God, to use these moments and use these times to revalue and relook at our lives, but also to find within these times the greatest hope, the greatest joy, the greatest peace in our hearts, and to turn our lives into something that becomes more meaningful, and live that by spreading and radiating that love of Christ, the belief in Christ and our God, who we must look forward to meeting and anticipate in order for us to open up our hearts even more and to live a life which is much more full from here, and that will allow ourselves also to celebrate like Irani, who today is on his way and on his journey, and to become partners with that by remembering him in our prayers, because the love and the prayers and the offerings and sacrifices of the church and of our lives and everything we do is something that remains eternally and that is continued and forever works through the church to the other side. Let us remember these things so we do not grieve like those who have no hope. Remind ourselves of the fleeting and the vanity of the fleeting moments and the vanity of this life, and make this life meaningful, more full, more complete, and allow our lives to eventually flourish and become nourished spiritually, so that the body, the mind, the heart, the grace, and everything around us becomes sanctified, becomes radiant, becomes light, and lives the celebration of a resurrected Christ. There aren't too many words that we can actually add to what he said in the service, but it is important for us to live the practicality of a living God, an experience of God, and not an idea of a logical God in our minds, because if we do that, we do remain fixed to this world, fixed to ourselves, fixed to our bodies, and fixed to a state which will always allow us to have fears and anxieties. Yet the freedom of Christ and the love of Christ is experienced in the what appears ironically as death to us, and yet is a freedom from our physical bodies. It's a freedom where we unite with our Maker and our Creator, and obviously we too must remember that the prayers and the offerings that we do are now going to be escorting Ioannis, and it is very important for us to continue to do that, to keep the memory alive within our lives, within our hearts, within our homes, and to remember to do that by showing the love that he taught us and to spread that to others around us. And also remember the love of God, because as man we are imperfect, and so was John, just like me and you and all of us, and yet we talk about a love of God that has grace, that is imparted with it, grace that joins and unites because of the deeds and actions and love that he showed, that we are now showing and participating in with others around us. Let us remember, therefore, to grieve, but to remember especially so, to grieve with hope, and to have the center and the core of our lives centered on the fact that Christ has trampled on death by death, and that death does not exist, and we too resurrect with him. We wish you with all our heart, we'll keep him in our prayers together as a body, as a church and a family. We must remember these are times that are difficult, but these are times where people must unite more, become one in body, one in spirit, and not only unite in body and spirit, but become one in Christ, where the joy and the difficulties and everything that we share will become much fuller, much more complete, and our lives will take meaning, and then we too will also be able to shout from the bottom of our hearts that we do expect the resurrection of the dead and the life of the age to come. We do live the kingdom that we are always praying for in the Our Father, where we ask every day in our prayers, and it gives us a different meaning and a hope in a world which today seems very, very difficult and challenging, and where the truth and our freedom and our lives become lived fully, and we experience the love of Christ, and we do not allow the problems, the imperfections and weaknesses, and the humanity and the sins to become more abundant, and to live a life that through these things we live even closer and more full in our lives to for ourselves and for our families and everybody around us. Christos Anesti, Zoe Sassas, Vosios Napavi, Panagenos Escapazi Pandati.
Θέλω να ευχαριστήσω τον Πάτερ Γιώργο για την όμορφη λειτουργία που έδωσε για τον πατέρα μου και στάθηκε δίπλα μας σε αυτές τις πολύ δύσκολες μέρες. Θέλω να σας ευχαριστήσω εσάς που συγγενείς και φίλοι που ήρθατε σήμερα να πείτε ένα τελευταίο αντίο στον πατέρα μου. Really like to thank everyone that's come today, and you know, to help us with this very difficult goodbye that we have to tell him today. As you all know, my father was a fantastic storyteller, and I hope that he passed it down to me. I wish I could tell you everything that he managed to fit into his 76 odd years, but that would take a lifetime. Ο πατέρας μου γεννήθηκε στην Αθήνα το 1945. Ήταν ο μικρότερος από 4 αδέρφια, παιδιά του Βασίλη και της Σταματίνα Μπαλάσης. When my father was born, the Second World War had just finished, and the world would enter a time of great prosperity and well-being, and my father's birth would have the same impact for many people in the future. My dad used to tell us a story when we were young, and he said, I was born at the end of the war, and the first thing my mother gave me was chocolate that the American GIs had given him. So whether that's a true story or an urban legend, I'm not too sure. My dad left Greece at 16 to join his brother Peter here in South Africa. He had been enrolled at Parktown Boys, but he had other plans. And so began the adventures of a young Ioanni. Εδώ γνώρισε τον Μπάμπη, τον Στέλιο και τον Γιώργο, και ξεκίνησε μια φιλία που κράτησε 57 χρόνια. In my dad's late teens, he met his best friends who would become his brothers, George, Stelio and Bobby, and they've been friends for 57 years. A friend of ours has a food franchise, and every Thursday, the three of them would get together and have a meal. So my friend on his Instagram page put a photo of the friends having lunch together, and he put a little caption at the bottom saying, look at these friends, 40 years together, and they meet every week to have lunch. So when I showed the photo to my father, he said to me, you better phone Dino and tell him it's not 40 years, it's 57 years and he must change it. So I said, Dad, it's too late now, but he insisted. Anyway, his strength of character, you know, he used to tell me that we grew up in Hillbrow. It was without parents, without anyone to look after us. And for him, it was important that he used to say to me, we never became ducktails or gangsters. We kept the morals and the values that our families had given us in Greece. And that was something he was very, very proud of. In his early 20s, he met a good Portuguese girl who would go on. To become the love of his life. Against all obstacles, especially my mom's dad, he succeeded and took my mom's hand, and the rest, as they say in the classics, is history. Together they built a beautiful family, as nothing was more precious to my father. Growing up in our home was filled with family and friends, and the family gatherings were always legendary. My sisters and I, we wanted for nothing when we were growing up. He instilled in us a love for family and taught us that good morals and values were above everything else, and your name was more important than anything. The way he treated my mother has become an example to us, and every day I try to emulate him as a father to my sons. My dad was always proud of us, especially his grandchildren, of which he had 9. And he was blessed that they were in his life, and it was something that was very important to him. My mom was always the rock in my dad's life, and she always centered him. It's because of her he was able to explore. I wish I could tell you of his success in business, but he was never comfortable speaking about it, and rather prefer to discuss more mundane philosophical things. I've received hundreds of calls from all over the world this week, and the consistency in all the messages has been the same. Your father was an honorable man, a gentleman. He always had time, and he really listened to everybody's story. Στην οικογένεια μας στην Ελλάδα, σας αγαπούσε και πάντα ήσασταν στην καρδιά του. Στον Μαϊστρέλη, ήσουν αδελφός του. You know, my dad, everything that was important to him was his family and his friends. You know, we laugh because so many of my friends are here and wanted to be here because they lived him and experienced him. He took every gap to try and be at the parties that we would have at home. So I would say, Dad, I'm having a braai with some friends over this weekend. And then he would phone me the day before and he would say, who's coming? And I'd say, mention some names. He says, okay, I'm going to make you something to serve. And then on the morning of the braai, he would phone me and go, what time are your friends coming? And I'd say, probably about 1:30, Dad. And then he would arrive at 2:00 with a dish, and he would take the gap and sit down, and there he was with us for the rest of the afternoon. So a lot of my friends got to know my dad very well, and I'm just proud that I see a lot of them here, and it means a lot to me. My dad still had a lot of life in him, but God obviously had other plans for him. I ask of all of you to remember and pray for him, and to live life like he did. Καλό παράδεισο.
Hello everyone, I'm Ioannis Balassis. I believe the best way for me to honor my papa is to give you a little bit of my experience with him. When I think about my papa, I think about three things usually: stories, lessons, and definitely food. We had the privilege of my papa cooking for us literally all the time. Papa would call me during the day and he'd say to bring him some ingredients, and then by the night we'd have a genuyo combination that he had come up the day before. His favorite thing to say after cooking was, "Ioannis, όχι υπερβολές, μα αυτό ήταν το καλύτερο μου ever." But to be honest, I believe the real reason my papu loved food so much was because when he was eating, he was always with family or friends, or when he was giving us food, he was giving us an experience that we could forever remember. Whenever I dropped off ingredients at my papu, which when COVID began was 2 to 3 times a week, I'd walk in and I'd really tell myself every single time, "Ioannis, you have to go home and study. You can't sit here and speak to papu for hours." And then I tell my papu, "Papu, mono tha mino ya deka lepta." But by then it was already too late. He'd sit down in his favorite chair, which I'm sure a lot of you experienced, with his dog Kukla sitting on top of him, looking over the room with him. And he'd start telling these stories. Stories about how he grew up, how he came to South Africa, how he met my Maia, how our family started. Just how he loved Greece, how he just experienced the world. You know, I really experienced the world through my papu's eyes when he would speak to me. And I could actually listen for hours, and I usually did. By the end of it, my Maia would already be coming home from work, and we'd have sat there the whole day just enjoying each other's company. And the thing is, my papu had this ability to keep everyone who listened entertained, and the way he envisioned his stories, he kept everyone captivated. He said them with such emotion, detail, and passion that you really felt what he was trying to explain to you. And a lot of my papu's stories actually, you know, he used to give you a lesson. The story would come because you'd say something and it would end up in him wanting to teach me something at least. And being a 22-year-old, sometimes, you know, I'd be like, "Oh, this one had, I don't know, this happened to this one and I wish it happened to me." Or my friends, someone I know is in Greece now and I wish I could be there. And my uncle always used to tell me, and I don't think I'll ever forget this, "Ξέρεις, Ιωάννη, πάντοτε βλέπουμε μπροστά μας, μα ξεχνάμε πόσοι άνθρωποι είναι στη σειρά από πίσω μας." Which means, you know, he always used to tell me, we have to be grateful because we're always looking at in the line of life all the people ahead of us, people, things that we don't have, that we wish we had. But he always used to turn around and say, you know, we never look back and we never realize the line behind us is actually often a lot longer than the line in front of us. And we should be grateful for that. And I do believe that through this philosophy, my papu was always so happy because he had become content with what he had. He was content with the life that he lived. He had no regrets. He really enjoyed just even sitting in his house that he spent his years building since he was 16. Even sitting and looking in his garden where he tended to his fruit and vegetables. He was just happy to be in his, you know, I don't know how to explain this actually. He was just happy to be him. He was happy to live his life to the fullest and have no regrets ever. And I'll always be thankful for the time I spent with my papu. And I hope he's really impacted everyone's lives the same way that he impacted mine. My papu really lived life to the fullest, and until we meet again, I hope I can emulate that in my own life.
met Kami in 1964. I was introduced to him by one of my other friends and brother to me, George Diondris, around the snooker table in Hebrew. At the same time, I met Bobby Mandilas, George Christidis, Vasulis Thermos, and Thanasi Dallas. Our friendship lasted for 57 years. He was 19, and I was just over 20. We had a beautiful life as young people. We enjoyed it, always respected it. We had our arguments, always. First, we had our friendship. We got married, all of us, one by one. We had children, grandchildren, but we are proud of them. Gianni loved life. He wanted to live forever. He used to sit down and talk, and he used to tell me, why God didn't give us 300 years to live? I will come to South Africa, I spend 1,000 years. And if I don't succeed, I will go to Australia and try my luck there. If I don't succeed there, no, you go plenty of time. I will go to Canada and then spend my last 50 years in this in my retirement. Gianni loved his family very, very much. It was his passion. And when I say family, I meant the whole family. Mary and the children. His family was the Rodriguez, the Balassis in Greece, the Gonzales, the Calvanis, the Giliotis, and the one I had to read from here is the Borigero. And when he used to talk about his family, it was, in a way, when he used to say Jose, he didn't say Jose, he used to say my cousin Jose. He used to say my cousin Teresa. To him, they were family. And that's, I think, something that I experienced, because I've never seen it anywhere else before. We used to talk on the phone at least twice a week. And that conversation will last for 30 minutes. And one of the items will come up, of course, I will ask him, what did you cook today for the trip? And he will, from the telephone, literally, we can visualize what the way he used to tell the story of how you cook. And eventually even make the sounds. And I'll take the onions, I will cut it, tak, 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 tak. Eventually you could actually taste the food while he was. But the last time I met him, it was on the 3rd of June, when I went to visit him. Doris prepared some dessert for the friends to have that day. And he says, come to the kitchen. And he made me taste the food. And he was begging me to stay, and I said, I'll come. Gianni was a very generous man. Very, very generous man. He loved his church. He loved his religion first and then the church. And he always, whenever he felt that he had to contribute. The church in Ioannis, all the lights and chandeliers, it was, he never said to anybody, Nobody knew about it. When I was in Greece a few years ago, I had a problem. I'm in the apartment I have there. And he says to me, I will give you the name of somebody to help you.
And I met the guy, and we started with a bit of, you know, fixing the problem that I have. And then we went to have a coffee, and he says to me, I'd like to tell you something, but please don't say to Mr. Balassi that I said so. He had a son who had a problem with his eye. And the only place that could be helped, it was the child to go on a specialist in Switzerland. And Johnny did that. He helped that child to get his vision back. It's something I don't even know if the family knows about it, but you know, I just had to say, because that was Johnny. That was Johnny. I will miss you.
Thank you. Regretfully, because of COVID, my dad would have really liked a large celebration. But I've promised that when all this craziness is over, we're going to have a big party to celebrate his life. Thank you.
this, the fourth, the fifth, the manifold, the major lift, the battle king composing hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah.